Hello and welcome to Arena Seva for the final time at the 29th Universiade. All is in readiness for the gold medal match in women's ice hockey. A breezy but clear evening in Krasnoyarsk as the 29th Universiade draws to a close tomorrow. It's just a minus 1 degree outside. That's pretty mild for this time of year in this part of the world, in central southern Siberia. And the Russian fans eagerly awaiting this match to see if they can successfully defend the title they took against this very same team, Canada, 2 years ago. So they both won their semi-finals in pretty impressive fashion. About 2,500 fans in. Quite interesting, they find themselves against the same team as in Almaty, Kazakhstan. These teams met as recently as last Friday in pool play, and it was a 4-2 win for the Russian Federation. They were probably better than that. So Canada defeating Japan 5-1, the Russian Federation 10-0. Over the United States. They are a goal scoring machine. A red machine is what they call themselves on their jerseys. And they are machine-like in both attack and defense. They have scored 55 goals to 3. So 2 10-0 wins over the United States certainly boosted their for and against. Switzerland and China also copped a bit of a hiding from the productive Russian offense. Canada through with 4 wins and that 1 loss to the Russian Federation, and 5-1 against Japan, a victory they set up pretty early. They were up 3-0 at the end of the first period. So a sprinkling of Canadian fans here, but overwhelmingly they're here to see if the Russian Federation can deliver. They've got a squad bristling with Olympians from last year in Pyeongchang. Canada, not so. They don't bring as much experience. They haven't included any players at senior representative level. So on that information alone, you have to favour Russian Federation to back up their win from last Friday and do it again in the gold medal game, which is just minutes away.
Please rise for the anthem of the International University Sports Federation.
Tune that has echoed around the chambers of universities for a couple of hundred years now. Gaudiamus, and our officials always like to wish them a good game. Julia Kindberger, I think, is from Austria, not Australia, but that's not too important right now, as the shake of the hands between Shabanova and Willoughby. Rozova will be the goalkeeping duties for the Russian Federation. She's outstanding. But it's interesting, it was Makushova who was goalkeeper in the semi-final. Vance, likewise for Canada, she's outstanding also. I think in that match against the Russians last Friday, it could have been a lot worse than 4-2. Just rotating the goaltenders, happy to do that, is Alexander Vedenikov and Alexei Chistyakov.
Thank you.
getting ready for the drop of the puck. And McCann, pretty useful player with 6 goals. And Pavlova, though, really one to watch and enjoy. He's so productive. 10 goals, 3 assists. Let's see how quickly. Oh, it's just off the skate of the referee there. Then cannons off the back of the goal. So a kind of an awkward start, really. But, they'll settle into their work quite quickly. Pavlova shoots it high. And a physical challenge in the corner. They're not going to be left wondering if they're tough enough, Canada, to take it up to the Russian Federation if they're to have any chance. They've got to exert some kind of presence on the ice. And it's pushed away by Shabanova. And Canada doing a good job, and not far away from deflecting it into the goal. With a couple of really good chances early. McCann right there. And just pushed out beyond the blue line. Well done by Kadyrova to delay the Canadian next attack. They come in once more through the legs of the Russian defender. Tidied up now by Danieva. Russians really been put under some pressure here in the opening moments. The first minute and a half belonging to Canada. Now down behind the Canadian goal. And Shtareva there, 68 for the Russian team. Shot coming, you know it. But, in the way was Bulkin. The moment of defence for the Canadians early, putting their bodies on the line for the shots at goal from the powerful Russian sticks. Kristiakova fires it up to center ice, and is Bratisheva defending Gentile. Nothing gentle about it. It's a turnover, and again the Russians quickly dispossessed in a dangerous part. Villeneuve, 6 goals, 5 assists for Villeneuve. Really one to watch for Canada if she gets any open opportunities. Bird caught in the corner by two defenders. They look a bit off their game at the moment, the Russian Federation. Here's a chance. And that's one taken by Stratman. It wasn't too powerful a shot. And Jukina did well to keep upright on the skates. All but overbalanced, chasing the puck. There she's again, squabbling forward on the boards. Jukina against Dodelin. 3 minutes gone. Cracking pace to this gold medal game. If it stays like this for 60 minutes, we'll all go away happy, highly entertained. But there's got to be a winner and a loser, of course. And they got the icing call there. With a couple of terrific chances. Villeneuve delayed a shot to the last second, as just dropping the thigh on it was Morozova. And the shot from Kalyakova. Knocked back into the corner by Wolf. It along the boards, and it's out past the blue line, so they get reset. Wolf, final line change for both teams. It's down in this corner. Wolf up to center ice again. And Tavares chases it to the corner, but there first was Wolf. Flicked it off a stick. It's going to favour Russian Federation there with a Batalova. Kadyrova loves to shoot, but lays that one off. The Pavlova. Nothing on at that time. Kudinova and Pavlova. Five goals between them yesterday against the United States. Pavlova just toppled over there on that far side. And a chance for both teams to refresh the lineups. It's Villeneuve in 26 out of the University of Moncton in New Brunswick. Villeneuve. Down she goes. throws the stick at the skate of the disappearing Russian. Yeah, tripping. I'm sorry, Katrin. So the first penalty play of the game. Could be costly. It nearly was immediately. Kanyeva just traps it with the skates. And here she has it again. Lays it down. Lines it a point. For the Russian Federation. You back them to score considering how productive they can be, but they weren't quite so good on the power play against Canada a few days ago. Turned it over here and dumped into the empty corner to buy some seconds. Sounded a smart play there. Just 70 seconds on the power play for Russia. Kadyrova across. Now Timofeeva chases it down. And it gets set further out and we're looking for the deflection off Kadyrova. Played in by Rogova that time. And the face-off will be in the Canadian defensive end. Kadyrova looking for a deflection. Earlier, Pavlova tucked in again and pushed over there. Timofeeva, she gets to her feet. What might have been still 45 on the power play. In the bin is Villeneuve, a player that Canada can ill afford to be without, at least in attack. Timofeeva. Stanwood sees it away. Pavlova, plenty of defence around her. There always needs to be. Rogova. Pavlova just lost it there. Not once, but twice and thrice. And that's made it a little bit easier for Canada to wind down this power play. Shabanova. Not be impressing the Russian coach Chistyakov. This has been a poor power play and they are back to full strength, Canada. Villeneuve comes straight out and straight away receives the puck. Canada back into attack. Full strength line and change a few players now as we the 7 minutes into the game. Nothing to show for it on the scoreboard yet. Both teams showing a great willingness to attack. And that was nearly Bouchard getting the first. Right in the face from Morozova. Berg tidying up Canada, bringing it up to center ice. Evades a couple. Takes a risk there against Staravojtova. Chop at the puck and there's a few around it. Canada under pressure back there, but now it's Balkan. See it away. Not far enough. Staravojtova was there. Wolf comes kindly forward for the Russians here. Two on one and... the keeper has been barreled. And Vance takes a heavy knock. Dobra Dieva there. Dobra Dieva Kabarovsk. Over there, didn't do too much to take anything out of the challenge on the keeper. I guess you don't expect to. And GK, as they're signified on the start sheets here, other than goaltender, if that's the term you're used to. They made the point during the bronze medal game here at these Universiade matches. The custodians in goal are referred to as keepers. Goalies. If you like goaltender, you'll still know what I mean. Line change for the Canadians. Opportunity down. He goes shocking up. Plenty of defence around it. Oh, good save. Forced after the shot from Stareva. Advance are being kept busy in the Canadian goal. Rebounds out to Rogova. Rogacheva had her hands full there, so she has to retreat now. She's heading off to be replaced. Shabanova plays it back. Well anticipated by the defence, though. Rogova. Centre-ice. Canadians have it once more. Nobody on the end of that pass, though. Shabanova has it again. With Pavlova for support, but Pavlova wants to get into a forward position. Timofeeva and Isaac. Some pretty good moments for both teams through the first 9.5 minutes, 9 minutes 16. Canada well in this. Willoughby giving as good as she gets there from Nadezhda Wolf. Bouchard takes it around behind the goal. It's a stick court. Chance at the steal here for the Russian Federation. They get back quickly enough. This is Willoughby, especially. Come down into Jack's third by McCann. Another line change for the Canadians. Also for the Russians. Tishova lays it down to the available player, and the shot is blocked from Kulishova. Vance does a good job. Kulishova asked the question of Vance, and she had the answer. So halfway through the first period. Nine shots to six so far. And the Russian Federation, just for three more. Stacey Colarossi having some encouraging words for the Canadian lineup. They've not conceded. That's a good sign early. Concerned look on that Canadian fan. Tishova in for the face-off for the Russian Federation. And Villeneuve. Won quite nicely by the Russian Federation. They're very efficient. He's getting a bit willing. So the temperature is rising in the Arena Seva. Russia not enjoying the dominance they had against the USA in their semi-final, that's for sure. Canada, a different proposition. It would have been no less than they were expecting. It is stolen in centre ice there by Dobrodeeva. Starovoitova comes in to help. that Willoughby takes it away. Good. Second defender does the job. The Canadian. Good. Still there, looking for the spill out of there. Comes up off the glass. Well, Spurs takes, of course, but you know what I mean. Talava. Deflected shot. Counted up the centre ice once more. And Vulcan. A lone run. McCann. Shot bounces off the keeper. Unable to get a good glove on it and secure possession, Morozova. And goal for Russian Federation, but they're on the break now. Shokina just pops it up rather unusual style behind the goal, and nobody was getting a stick on that. Must have been 15, 20 feet in the air. Skaravatua. Canada crashing through the defence. Bouchard pull up. Ganyeva. A bit of help. Cross to Skareva. Playing themselves patiently out of trouble. Skareva. Advance. Stopping the shot from Pavlova. Pavlova just avoids the stick of the defender, but can't avoid Vance. Pavlova at 178 centimetres, quite tall in this Russian lineup. A lot of long levers and a very fast stick from Pavlova, who scored three in the first period against the Americans yesterday. Boost her goal tally. 7:20 left in the first. Gold medal game, and it's the Russian Federation in the white shirts taking on Canada. And a replay of the gold medal game from 2 years ago in the previous Universiade. Kazakhstan won that day 4-1 by the Russian Federation. They got a dozen players backing up from that game and 11 from last year's Winter Olympics. So they are the ones with the experience at senior level. Rogova, too much defence there, and then he sticks in to Denier. Backpedaling effectively, Canada, to give themselves time and space. Towards their own goal, though. And the Russians make a line change. They weren't in a position to press too high. Soft turnover, centre ice, someone's lost a stick. Very casually by Derkacheva. Save having to be made there by Morozova. Stick still on the ice. It's not causing a problem to anybody. McCann. Ganyeva scorched her into the corner and dispossessed her. Somehow got it away. Neatly done. Derkacheva. Storeva. Open shot. Couldn't be taken, and that time it was Shokina. He's got a couple of goals. Didn't get a third. Certainly plenty of attention being paid there to Thierrette, trying to take that shot. Batisheva backed away from it now, and Ash's got it again. I think they did well. Batisheva drawn a couple of defenders in there, and that's opened up the space and the opportunity to shoot. Tie up the defenders behind the goal or on the boards, you can squeeze it out quickly. Jupina, no. Bratishva also denied. Oh, that's a bit sloppy, but they were making a couple of changes. Nikolaeva not expecting too much out of that gentle push towards the opposition goalie. Canada squeezed against the board. They look up for a penalty. They don't get it. Federation looking to use the boards to escape. And they've done that. Fofana goes back. And we'll have an icing there. Come back to the attacking end for the Russian Federation. Stareva just lost track of it for a moment and got a nice nudge in the back. And it was Van Verenburg who had the squeeze on. And she looked back towards the referee asking, surely you can find some help for me there. No whistle. Kadirova. Being deflected, I don't think that would have been a chosen option to go into that corner. Another shot. Bounces out through the neutral zone. So Canada take their fortune. I'd like to have seen that cleanly taken by Morozova. Morozova. Good. And there's a penalty coming. It'll be in favour of the Russian Federation. They get the extra player on. Let's see what they can do here. Empty net's okay for the team awarded the penalty. And Rogosheva lays it off. Still got the extra field player out. 6-on-5 essentially. That's a lot of traffic around the goal. I'll do this is quite. This is delayed penalty is taking some time to accrue. Russians playing keepings off at the moment while they look for a good shot. Shokina. Still they have it. Ganyeva. She wants a try. Ganyeva again. This is amazing possession retention by the Russian Federation. 2 minutes 50 left. Still got a delayed penalty favouring Russian Federation. As Dugacheva takes it down again. Shokina! Ah, it's played off the frame of the goal, I think, that time. And finally, the penalty can be imposed on Canada. Wow, what a passage of play that was. You have to wait a long time to see a team keep possession in that situation with the delayed penalty, and Berg is off to the box for that hit. And there were numerous opportunities here for the Russian Federation. Interference, the call on Annie Berg out of Brock University in St. Catharines, Ontario. 5-on-4. And that last minute, crazy minute for the Russian Federation, I suppose, was like a power play of 6-on-5. It's the empty net. Pavlova. I'll tell you what, she's doing a good job, Jessica Vance. The University of Saskatchewan. Pavlova gets looks like this. She often takes them nicely, but a fairly sharp 40-degree angle, I suppose. A young fan. I wonder if that toddler will turn into a hockey player. Too young to have to go to school tomorrow, so a late night is fine. And dribbles across the face of goal. Minute 50 left in this first period. It's been a very entertaining one. Oligova plays it across. Might come back to her. Inching in towards the goal. And the defenders just didn't come out towards Shabanova. She was inching in closer and closer. Remember, Canada shorthanded. There's still a minute left on the... 6 left on the power play. Minute 41 in the first. And they'll go to the break with their heads up if they can see it, to nil all Canada. Russian Federation with far more shots on goal. Another one that can't find the net. Gee, they're having some opportunities. Batalova plays it across. Olegova waiting in the middle. Doesn't come to her. Caught behind goal once more. And Pogacheva, one of those in there, along with Shokina. And they squeeze the puck free. Fatalova. No. Doesn't like the angle. Waiting for defenders to get caught out. Fatalova leaves. Oh, it's behind Fatalova. That should just about see Canada return to full strength. There's still 7 seconds left. The puck pops back into center ice and a shorthanded shot themselves, Canada. Now they're back to full strength for the last 30 seconds of the first period of the gold medal game. The Russian Federation has not lost a game. They've been in sweet control of the puck the whole of this first period. Laid off by Pavlova, comes around behind the goal. She's down. There's Vance. Pavlova and Kadyrova. Now Kadyrova with arms out saying, I didn't do anything. McCann there for Canada. Kadyrova is pushed out of the way in the end by Forbear. 12 seconds. Can be enough. Face-off deep in Canadian territory. Kadyrova bashed into the boards. Quickly up without complaint. They're squabbling four of it. Along with the Shabanova. And that'll be it. Nice feisty end of the first period. No goals. Canada survive. Shots about 20 to 11 by my count. So nil all at the end of the first period. Dodelin first off. Plenty of discussion, I'm sure, for both coaches. They'd be well pleased not to have conceded, as the shots 20 to 11. 4 minutes of penalties for the Canadians. Face-offs pretty even, but the majority of shots enjoyed by the Russian Federation. It's, they're looking good for it, they just haven't scored yet. The Canadians can smile for the moment, they're not behind. Let's have a look at some of the action out of the first. Thank you. truck certainly looked like it crossed the line there, and that's why Kadyrova was protesting. So I wonder if that's a bit... Welcome back to Arena Seva. Getting set for the second period of the gold medal game between the Russian Federation and Canada. It's nil all at the moment. 20 shots to 11, though. And face-offs also favouring the Russian Federation slightly, 8-7. And a very controversial moment late in that first period when the puck seemed to cross the line of the Canadian goal. It wasn't given. All sorts of headwear available. Let's have a look at some of the pictures and images of this first period and the people enjoying it. She's been pretty busy in goal, has been Jessica Vance. She's done a great job to keep out the Russian attack through the first 20 minutes. Everyone's having a great time with the full house at the Arena Seva. It's been a pretty physical encounter. And we might see at the very end of this little highlights package, the moment we're talking about, with the puck seemingly crossing the line, but there was not a decision in favour of the Russian Federation. So, I think the whistle may already have gone. Kadyrova didn't think so. Anyway, the score stands at nil all. An overhead shot seemed to suggest that if the whistle hadn't gone, it could well have been a goal. But as I once heard it said, if ifs and buts were sweets and nuts, we'd all have a Merry Christmas. It didn't happen, so it's nil all. Shots to 11 and nothing for it. Timofeeva loitering around center ice. Let's see who comes up to take the face off. Pirogova in 13. But, it does look like Timofeeva. Perhaps Stratman. Still 15 seconds left before we can get the second period underway. Earlier, Japan secured the bronze medal in overtime in sensational style, defeating the USA 2-1. It's nil all here. Stratman and Timofeeva go at it at the start of the second period. Russian Federation left to right. Canada in the red shirts. And, as always, the prominent maple leaf on their uniform. Now that one just got away. Now Shibanova. Vance makes the save and she's immediately under pressure. Shibanova gathers it up once more. They had Pavlova open at the blue line, chose not to use her, and not much came of that attack. Canada can start to press. Pavlova back to defend this time. And a chance here for Dergacheva. Goes to the empty corner. Bouchard for Canada. Back along the boards. And Starego is there. Really having to play a physical style, Canada, to escape the clutches of the Russian attack. You've got to meet them on physical terms. Say that in women's hockey there's supposed to be a little less contact, though I haven't seen it here. It's been full on. And the players have not complained. And the officials have been in reasonably good control of it. Shokinar. The chance is over the top from Dergacheva. She could at least have put it on target. She was well above the ahead of Vance with that shot. Bouchard. Bouchard wraps around. Canada playing it to where it really wasn't. Teammate in good position, so Russian Federation is at the defense. Bring it out to center ice. Whoa! Dupinard coming together there with Berg. And I'm not surprised that it's Berg who's off to the penalty bin. Yeah. She was putting the opponent in danger here. Just cleaned up Jupiter. Just dropped the shoulder in. And Stacey Colarossi has to work shorthanded. See what she can do from the sidelines. Only so much. 5-on-4. Russian Federation well due the score with the amount of shots they've had. Canada with a nice little fortuitous rebound off the boards. Not afraid to press high. 4-on-5. Shabanova. Along the boards they come back out past the blue line. Just neutralise again. Canada doing a great job here. A little lack of organisation. Offensive push at the moment. Pavlova lays it back. Sloppy touch in the centre again, and Canada soak up the seconds. Play the puck to where nobody is. 70 seconds left on the power play. Pavlova looks up. Who's there? Gogacheva goes high once more. Attacking zone. Shocking up. Ganyeva. Stareva. And across the face it goes. Shocking her again. Looking for the right option. Right behind the goal. Is the way at the moment. Across to Ganyeva. Stareva waiting in front of the goal. Crowd getting a bit impatient. I think that the Russian Federation should have scored by now. Shokina. Ganyeva. Must shoot. And gets out by Vance once more. This defence is good. If they frustrate to the Russian Federation for long enough, and they could get one on the counter. Vance drops to the knees. Looks after it. Kadyrova clattering into her opponent there. And, being Weber. And, Kotalova goes back. Just not stringing the passes together so well this evening. It's against better opposition. The Canadians seem to have learnt from their last encounter, which Russian Federation won 4-2. This is a solid effort from them. Doesn't seem to be wanting to go anywhere. But half of both teams over the puck trying to dig it out. Now it's free. And to turn it over once more. Good job. Stareva. Has put to the Russian Federation off their game. And arrives once more, the Canadians able to stop the advance. And the Arkiv is on the Russian Federation at the moment. Just won't fall for them, and so Stanwood sends it back up towards the blue line as it looks like the penalty coming. No, it's been waved off. slamming into the goal. There's Dobrodeva. She's okay. The goal needs reattaching. Dobrodeva. Well, she was assisted into the goal there really by Stanwood. Stratman trying to do just that. Also, Balkan. A little bit optimistic trying to pick up Milošova with that pass when there are two Canadians there. Weber plays it back. Balkan back at the point. Can't get a tour at the moment. Finally, the pressure relieved for the Russian Federation. What can they make of it? Left it behind, did Porogova. Shot from point blank range. Her Villeneuve. It was the best opportunity of the game, I think. Villeneuve, one on one with Morozova. Gave her nothing to look at. Pavlova pushes it high into the right. Gregoris. Quick turnover. And Pierrette has to rush back in there. She gets to know the boards a bit better. Pierrette back on her feet. Takes it up the middle. Boris couldn't secure it. Russia through traffic here. And the shot from Filagova. That was a slicing move from Filagova. Shabanova. She's down, now she's up again. Needs to be quick. Puck caught up in the corner. Willoughby. She's up and away again. Line change for both. And we're 11:48 left in the second period. Where's this goal going to come from? They've both squandered opportunities, I think it's fair to say. Villeneuve with a terrific opportunity a couple of minutes ago. McCann thought she had it in there. She's locked in against the boards now. 15, she can't do anything. Kadyrova squeezes it out. Stavatova. McCann clears it to centre ice. Russia gets set once more. Diagonally to the corner. Who wants to chase it in? Karavotova was there. 22. Just looking for the loose puck. She's in to make the challenge. And now she needs to get on the skates because Hamill's got another one-on-one. And Morozova. Bird with the shot. Two best chances of the second period, undoubtedly, Canada's. Villeneuve and Berg. This is an inspired performance so far from the overwhelming underdogs, if I can put it that way. Crowd trying to lift the Russian Federation now. Where's this goal going to come from? Dupina. Down and up again quickly. Canada seems to have come into this match with a firm decision to match the Russian Federation physically. Up the middle. Horogova. crashes into Vance. Bouchard. And Balkan. Barnaba has lobbed it back in to the Russian attacking zone. Bouchard sees the open player. They took advantage of the line change by the Russian Federation there. They were short at the back. Very smart play coming from Canadians today. Crowd finds voice again. Pavlova. Still no. The goals were coming so easily to her last night. Not today. Pavlova. And Canada on the march once more. This has got great pace about it. Another little line change. Likewise, the Russian Federation. Villeneuve gets it back from Gentile. Weber plays it to the corner. Not much happening there for Canada, but there's Luboris battling hard for it. Comes again. This is one on two. Russian Federation has it. They're really having trouble getting out of that defensive zone. Sticks on it all the time. Here's a good example. Villeneuve after it. A shot. Villeneuve in there for the scraps. Van Berenburg sent it in the first time. And still they can't clear. This is a sterling performance from Canada. Really surprised how resolute they are. In defence is nearly another tap in. Luboris. Russian Federation under all sorts of pressure. They just cannot keep possession at the moment. Now they've freed up a shot for Stareva. Undo it. 7 minutes left and a bit in the second period. Shot just wide. Morozova under all sorts of pressure here. Players down in the crease. It's a mad scramble out there. Bouchard looking for it. Bouchard is out of feet. It's gone. It's picked up Potagova. This is crazy hockey. Worthy of a gold medal game. And that's what we've got. Fioret back in defence. Malkin trying to help out now. Comes in and steals it away from the scrap on the boards, and she's brought to her knees. Up she gets though, nice and quick. And helps relieve the situation for Canada. There'll be some exhausted players out there. Big hit on one of the Russian players. It's waved off, no penalty. Big line changes everywhere. Players have got to be exhausted. Dodelin brings it up. Canada. And the big defender just backs off now. Ganeva takes it to the corner, but she's not there first. Oh, another big collision. Face to face. Officials rule nothing on it. Against some tired, sore bodies at the end of this one. Jupina. Does a swivel, comes away without the puck. Player dives into the net. And who is that? That's Villeneuve crashing into the goal. Well, let's just take a deep breath. That was madness. Dobra Dejeva also. And then Anna Kulishova is being sent to the box. So this is interesting. Total shots now, 26 to 21. Remember, it was 20 to 11 at the end of the first period. So 10-6 in the second. And Canada getting much more even share of the play in offense. Yeah, Kalishova going to sit the next 2 minutes out, unless, of course, there's a goal by the Canadians. This was Berg. Okay, we're ready to resume the battle. I did go to the pool match between these two teams, which Russian Federation won 4-2. Canada had a power play late in the third period of that game and did not even get a shot away. So good was the power play defense of the Russian Federation. What about now? That's a Bouchard. Dives at the puck. Bouchard, up and at him, fires it across the goal, comes off the official, in that corner, and Stanwood swings him back into attack. Nice interception, protected there by Dugachova in the first instance. Soaking up the seconds, using the boards. Dugachova in the sandwich there. Forfar comes away. Forfar looks around. Wrap around. Not effective. Shotgunner. Just lobs it down the ice. Dugachova. A shorthanded attempt. Would have been an inspiring goal for the Russian Federation. They've just been put off their best here. Shot that time coming in the first time from Bird, and still around the goal. Canadians claiming something. Stratman gets up. Face full of ice, I think. Morozova. Willoughby, Stratman, Provodova down as well. There's the puck under the body now, and trying to finish it off was Gentil. And just about everybody was around the crease in the end. 18 seconds left on the power play for Canada. Through the traffic, Bolton rounds it up, sends it again, and they're back to full strength now, the Russian Federation. Shabanova back to pick it up for Russia, drops it back to the center, nicely collected. Chava leaves it behind her, shocking her across the goal. Stareva there leaves it. Just a couple of wrong options being exercised there. And Van Verenberg takes it up. Blocked, Villeneuve had it again. Morozova certainly knows she's in a game. The puck coming at her from Canadian sticks very regularly. That's at the other end too, but Canada really have won this second period, even if it's not reflected in the scoreline. They've been superb. 2.5 to go in the second. Still no goals in the golden game, if you like. It's the gold medal up to grabs. Might we be forced to overtime like we were in the bronze medal game? Japan only needed a few seconds of it to settle the issue. A long way from that, but where's the goal going to come from? Fired in by Gentil. Ganeva shuffles it away. Back it comes. Canada looking to make a line change, so not too much pressure on the outlet. Gerglin picks it up. Pavlova. Oh, good pass. Left behind her, though. Timofeeva couldn't control it, and she's off to the bench. Bouchard. Well, she got back in enough numbers. Kupina crushed against the board, loses the puck. Canada with another chance. And, played across by Willoughby. Not so much a shot as a cross. Van Berenburg. On the ice, picks it up. Kulishova. And has a little hack at the disappearing Villeneuve in possession now for Canada. Villeneuve away from a couple. Villeneuve on the angle towards Morozova and then crashed into the boards. Gets up exhausted, she'll be looking for some relief, and that's where she goes, Villeneuve. She's been replaced. Oh, big turnover here. Van Berenburg. Save Morozova. Van Berenburg will think that she really should have put that one away. What a soft turnover. This is happening way too often from the Russian Federation's point of view. Morozova. Well, in fairness, it was hit straight at her. Van Berenburg, no. At least make the keeper move. Would be a message out of that, I would have thought. Anyway, we stay somehow at nil all in the gold medal game. Shotgun. And that is the end of the period. Well, what an amazing game. It's not being played out as expected. Hot favourites, the Russian Federation, cannot find the goal. Timofeeva, they've just got to stay patient and believe it will come. But Canada, their self-belief has got to be sky high after really dominating that second period. We've got no goals. We've got a great game, though. Let's take a moment to consider what's happened and what's ahead of us. We've got a very exciting 20 minutes. The Canadians are thrilled to be in touch with the red-hot favourites, and now they actually lead on shots, 28-27. Face-offs 12-10 to the Russian Federation. Nobody scored, obviously, on the shorthanded opportunities. No doubt Canada won that second period. The shots in the first period were 20-11 to Russia. done a great job. They dominated that second period. You know, the Russian Federation scoring an average of 9 goals a game. They got none so far. Well, it couldn't be a better stage for a gold medal game, all tied up after two periods. It's the Russian Federation and Canada. And the thought occurred to me just as we went to that second break that with the Russian Federation averaging 9 goals a game and unable to score so far in this one, you have to say that Canada is playing the game of their lives here. They actually dominated the shots on goal in that second period, 17-7, to move ahead 28-27 overall on that stat. Some of the action out of the game so far. With a minute until the resumption. I think it would have been interesting to be in the change rooms listening to Alexander Ludenikov and Alexei Chistiakov. The team of the Russian Federation would have been told in no uncertain terms they're going to have to find something in this last 20 minutes. I'm going to leave it to the risk of sudden death overtime. Canada, they have been wonderful. Particularly Jessica Vance in goal. Can she do it for another 20 minutes? Well, their confidence will be good, Canada. Winter Universiade. It's been a great experience. And I think Stacey Colarossi, coach for the Canadians, must be so proud of the effort they put in. They leave themselves in contention after two periods, awaiting our first goal. Possession falls the way of the Russian Federation to start the third. Matsumafieva bumps it up towards the corner. And Canadian defence plays it smart behind the goal. And Berg. Berg has had a couple of spells in the penalty area. Left the team shorthanded, but the way they've played out the penalties in defense, Kenner, has been a feature of the game as well. Bolton just left it behind him. No problem, though, for the defense ultimately. Willoughby. Turnover, McCann. And Bouchard wasn't far away from putting a good shot on it. McCann's still there. Bouchard. Shot blocked and the second one, and Morozov has done well. Two good saves in succession. And the puck is just flying at her. 22-year-old. Average age of the Russian Federation team is 21. National State University of Physical Education and Sport. She attends. A lot of the athletes like to study phys ed, sports science. Up and beyond the center ice, Gentile has it for the Canadians. Come on. Nikolaeva. Helped along to the corner, and the Russian Federation makes a bunch of full line change there. Shabanova. And Stadovoitova. Stadovoitova's! And a stick on it, maybe, from Faubert to send it off direction. Shot coming at the other end quickly from Weber. I think you get both teams. I was to make an observation slightly on the negative side of it, so that their execution in front of goal has not been so good. I give full credit to the keepers and the goaltenders, but the shots could have been better directed. Absolutely surrounded there, Willoughby. Aliakova weaving away around the ice and again not on target. As much looking for a rebound off the keeper, I think, as trying to find the net. Kadirova watched her in the warm-up and her shooting was unbelievable. Kadirova, 2 goals yesterday against the United States, barely had a look today. Turnover and Fofana. Morozova bats it away. Survive another serious challenge. The Russian defense is struggling. Kadirova can't get a stick on it. This is great play. Berg plays it behind the goal. Berg picks it up again. Wobbly old puck. Berg. Morozova. Well, I'll be buying a drink for Morozova, the Russian team, if they get through this. Fofar loses the stick in the contact. Minutes gone in the final period. Canada still dominating. They've come restarted where they left off at the end of the second. Oh, that was nearly a great chance for Canada. It still might be. It looked like it came off from Delgachova. Starova. Squeezed back towards the back of the Canadian goal. Shabanova waits for it at the point. Can't get it to her yet. Canada are just out muscling. The Russian Federation at the moment, they're not backing away from any challenge. Chupina. Oh, yeah, she skates away, thinking that was nearly it. Kupina has been at the bottom of a really heavy challenge, just barely got to her feet. Advances there, takes control of the puck. What a goal, huh? Looks up, trying to look for an open channel and sticks flying. Defense is trying to obstruct the view of the keeper. The defense is trying to get in the way of the shot. And Vance drifted the right way. Shock in a down in a heap. That was earlier. Almost 5 gone in the third period. Shabanova. That pass across the ice. Another face-off win for the Russian Federation, but they can't keep possession for long. McCann. Made some fantastic interceptions. as Canada. Another one there from Berg. Able to win that challenge too. Oh, losing a footing, Faliakova gets up quickly. Jack Ganeva. Faliakova. And that one too high. It took a deflection, to be fair. Face off in the attacking zone for the Russian Federation. Timofeeva goes up as usual to take it when she's on. Kalaeva plays it across. Not effectively controlled by Timofeeva. Just the passes. The work's just not as tidy. Sometimes you can't put your finger on why that is. The skills you had yesterday aren't quite there 100% today. You've done them tens of thousands of times, but this is what Canada's been able to achieve today. Put the Russian Federation off their best game, and they work it up to center ice once more. Chance of a little breakaway here. Kadirova. And Willoughby. Sprint up the ice from Willoughby. Nice end-to-end stuff again. And the puck goes into the crowd. And so we can all just take a breath once more. So 13 and 7 seconds left in this third period of the gold medal game. Still, the Canadian defence, so Kadirova, I don't think she was on a preferred side there, and that one balloons into the crowd. Shots now 33 to 30 favouring Canada. Stanwood. 2 minutes. All right, 5-on-4. Well, rule that as deliberate. Colarossi, well, nods the head there, maybe not in agreement, but within the fact that what they're going to have to do now, and that is defend like they never have before. They have a couple of times before. They've survived a couple of penalties already, Canada. Is this the moment of the game where the Russian Federation finally takes the expected control? With the numerical advantage. They've got the experience. Plenty of Olympians from last year. Plenty backing up from 2 years ago. Shotgun plays it to the middle, and the shot over the top from Stareva. Cut off by Shabanova once more. Getting in closer. Vance not troubled by that one. Playing it around at least with some precision this time. Shabanova. Rogacheva's pass to the far side. A little wild. Shabanova off the boards. See if they can suck some defenders into the corner. Not buying that, Canada. Oh, that shot might have taken a glancing blow off the frame. Got a Godova. Shabanova plays it quickly off to the side, but Vance has got it again. And the officials have to come in and settle things down. Shotgun with it, walks away with a smile, but still 32 seconds left on the power play. What a Gova. Oh, it's actually off the glove, not the goal. Well done again, Vance. Russian Federation, good job getting it in the zone. Kajima! Out of nothing, finally. Vance is beaten. And Liana Ganeva. Finally finds a way to separate these two teams from Tatarstan. She will never have scored a more important goal than that one. Ganeva took a chance from well out. Kadyrova was right there and was happy to see it go through and pass to Ganeva. Powerful shot, plenty on it, a little unsighted, of course, was Vance, but that's how it is when the shot comes from distance. And we have a lead. Finally, nearly halfway through the third period. And Ganeva is just going to open the floodgates. Well, what can Canada do in response? A most unexpected way for that goal to come. But Ganeva maybe spotted a channel, backed herself, felt good over the shot, and pulled the trigger. Stratman dueling at the top of the crease there with Ganeva. They won't be feeling the cause as Rosberg sends it towards the goal, nothing really on it. River doing a good job with Berg. Bakalova taking a time. Time is now on the side of the Russian Federation. Ganeva sends a high shot towards Canadian keeper. Vance had that one well caught. Nice, desperate, outstretched touch there from Villeneuve. Played to safety by Batisheva. One nil will do it, of course, but it is a surprising scoreline to everyone, I think, that it's taken so long, such a small lead to be established. Federation not out of trouble just yet, that's for sure. There's Nikolaeva plays it behind her. Nikolaeva. Got a chance here. Shukalin. Oh, Stareva nearly. Rogova is setting up more like the Russian Federation we've known over the past week or so. Scoring 55 goals in six games, but only one in this one. It might be the most important. Chucklin has a shot. Vance is there with a left glove. Chucklin. Another one. Got to go back. And a bit of a fight bubbling over there. Rogova heads away from the fracas. 9 minutes to go. There's some of the action around the goal mouth. in the crease. Vance was probably beaten in a way we didn't expect. She'd been so solid, so physical, very, very confident, advancing towards shots. There, Starova nearly had the second, and that would have perhaps put the match to bed. So 2 years ago, the final standings were Russia, Canada, USA, China, Japan, Kazakhstan, and Great Britain. Well, Japan, courtesy of the bronze medal match victory, they get the bronze, so they've bumped the United States down a place from 2 years ago. Canada can't find an equaliser. And we're looking at the same top two. Tougher affair. Kadyrova. Kadyrova likes that angle. Berg. On the diagonal. Vitalova. Shova loses out in that contest. And Loris back towards the goal, but the defense is there once more. Conceded so few goals. They've got both boxes ticked to the Russian Federation. They score plenty, they concede few. And three goals conceded in six games and nearly seven. Two of the three they conceded were against Canada last Friday. The only other team to score against the Russian Federation was Japan in an 8-1 win for the Russian Federation. 7:54 left. Shokina allowed to advance. Shokina nearly got the 1-2. Starova. Happy just to work it around. Soak up the seconds, retaining possession. Got a go over. The puck is at this end. Russian Federation are on track. The neutral zone. Players come out. Canada makes the change. Yurigova. Working with Dugacheva initially. Yurigova. Well organized defense. Players in the corners. Pavlov is back on in 89. See if she can settle the issue. Gets a chance in front of goal. Kadyrova sniping away at Willoughby. Willoughby's done well though. No icing on that call. Gentil. Gentil allowed to go. Here's the turnover though. Oh, Kadyrova, magic. Could have worked with a stick to catch the puck and take it all the way to the corner, but there's three waiting for her. Canada inevitably come away with it, but Kadyrova puts the stick down and she gets it back. And he's got an unerring presence on the rink. Under 6 minutes to go now. Stacey Colarossi just checks the clock. What's left? What can we do? Who do we play? Who's got the ability and the energy to create something for Canada? Yukina getting crashed into the boards. Berg leaves it behind. Yukina once more thinks about the long shot. pressure. They're working hard in here to try and create the turnover. Just about done that. Just needed some support. Wasn't there. Three Russian players waiting back on the blue line. Half a mind on defense at this point is Berg. Down to the corner. She's playing a lone hand there, though. Cut off in front of the keeper. That was an interesting choice made by Provodova. She left Provodova unsighted, but knew what she was doing. And played in by Labrie. Best moment of attack for Canada in the last few minutes. Stareva. Stareva takes on Labrie. Wraps around looking for the open player. Can't find Kolodova. Villeneuve. Not much on that one. Needs a more powerful shot. Get past Morozova. Four to go. This is the gold medal game. Russian Federation and Canada. Krasnoyarsk crowd happy with the scoreline at the moment. They have to be very patient. Pavlova has put some pressure on, try to keep it down that end. She was one against three, and the puck spills out of play. Fresh troops on the ice for the Canadians. They're going to throw everything at the next 3 minutes 50. Try and force it to overtime. Try again on the face-off in the neutral zone. Timothy over there for the Russian Federation. Kadyrova waiting for her chance with the puck. Patalova though. The stick of Timofeyeva. Kadyrova loses balance in front of the goal. Skating quickly to get back in defense now. Berg pulls it back across the face. That was nearly a chance for Gentile to do something with it. Penalty coming here. It'll be against the Canadians. So Weber heading to the cooler. Oh, this is terrible news for the Canadians, which is tripped the player going past. Weber hangs ahead, looks up at the scoreboard and the time left, and this is a real blow for the chances of the Canadians. Didn't look like there was much contact, but if there was enough for the trip, that's how the official saw it. So Alexei Chistiakov, he's got the whiteboard out. He's got clear instructions about what to do with his power play. Yeah, it'll do his nerves a lot of good. If they could just get the second goal, I'm sure a lot of the crowd feels the same. Yes, there are some Canadian supporters here, and they've been well entertained and very proud of their team. Time's running out, and Canadians are shorthanded. Dardava into the corner. Patalova. We don't have to do anything here. Just look at the clock. Shot is wide from Pavlova. Kadyrova fires one in. Vance at the second attempt takes it, and a Russian player sent to the deck. It was Kadyrova. She's never far away from the action or the conflict. Okay, change of line. Still a minute 28 on the power play. Kadyrova. Oh, whoa! That was Fulbert, just knew she was coming, turned around and says, you're not getting any closer to my goalkeeper. Looking after your mates, as we say. Caught in the corner. This doesn't suit Canada. Where a short-handed goal was going to come from, but just missed it there. Another goal, but they want to get caught betwixt and between the Russian Federation. Not too much about defense, though. They go for the killer blow here. Still 50 on the power play. Not a goal. Shibanova plays it into this strong by Barenberg. Players down. Comes out to Kodogova. Russians venture out past the blue line again as they must. Kodogova waits for the new line to take shape. Kadirova! Kadirova could have done a little bit better there. Villeneuve, solo effort from her. Canada back at full strength for the last minute and 20 seconds. What can they do? Atalova. Allowed to keep possession a long time there, Atalova. Ganyeva. Whoops, that one's wobbled its way through outer space, back into the rink here at Krasnoyarsk. Took a big deflection. ...63 seconds for the Russian Federation to see this home and secure the gold medal. Face off at the Canadian end. Vitalova. Canadian fans looking for something special. Needs a miracle from here. Timofeeva wins the face-off. Kadirova. Shot rebounds, comes out to Vitalova, intercepts it, keeps it away from Berg. Vitalova. 45 seconds left. Canadians all but done here. It's got to go to the face-off now. I think the keeper wanted to set her players in motion, but that was too risky for Vance. Well, that had to be made. Vitalova did well. Berg was free otherwise. Top button's undone now for the nervous Alexei Chistiakov. He's a coach last year in Pyeongchang and 2 years ago in Kazakhstan. So he's been with a lot of these players. 11 backing up from the Winter Olympics last year and 12 indeed from 2 years ago. For Canada, Stacey Colarossi, can she pull something out of the hat? And her players win the face-off and go from there. Full house at Arena Savat. Shocking up. Now Canada have it, but only briefly. Berg. Under half a minute. One shot might be all they need. Berg. Berg. Take. Oh, no. What's happened? An offside for it.
Push that way.
Yeah. Left-hand shot, take control. We
don't have a left, TV. Berg thought she was away. The whistle had gone. A little slow to hear it. Oh, 15 seconds. And the empty net. And they score. They took the keeper off, of course. I think Ustareva, who settled it. Indeed it was. What choice did Canada have but to empty the net? Shtareva palmed it down, and from, well, halfway really, smack in the middle of the Canadian goal, and that will be that. With 11 seconds left, Shtareva has done it. It took some doing. And the crowd counting it down. And up they go. They're all on their feet at the Arena Seva. Oh, what a nervous match that was. And the look on Alexei Chistiakov's face tells you that was hard work, because Canada provided mighty opposition today. And really, we must applaud them. They've gone down by a couple, but the empty net goal at the end perhaps flatters the Russian Federation. They've got the job done, though. Sometimes you win a little ugly, and that's been the case for the Russian Federation today. They just romped through their pool matches, hottest of favourites to win their semi-final, and they did that 10-0. What was the score going to be against Canada? Well, Canada had other ideas, and we thank them for their effort, the way they played, and the spirit in which they played, and the feistiness with which they played. But again, the Russian Federation, just too good. Great game. And we got the medal presentation just a few minutes away. We'll look forward to that. I'm sure most of the crowd will stay for that. They'd love to see it happen. 42-34 the shots in the end. So the Russian Federation really improved late in the game, after they were down on that stat by one after two periods. And the face-offs pretty decisive in favour of the Russian Federation, 28-15. Look at, again, some of the action out of this incredible last game of the women's hockey program. Krasnoyarsk, Winter Universiade 2019. last of the action really in that game, and a few players like Caitlin Willoughby devastated that they didn't quite get across the line. But I hope that she's comforted by the silver medal that is coming her way. They put up a tremendous fight. We got a game worthy of the gold medal match, that's for sure. So the scene set for the medal presentation. Ceremony. It's being done with some pomp and ceremony.
And medalists of the women's ice hockey tournament of the 29th.
A lot of medals and mascots need to be gathered for this. Over 60 players involved.
Медали вручает член исполнительного комитета ФИСУ Пенина Кабенге Олеговеса. The medals will be presented by Executive Committee Member ФИСУ Пенина Кабенге Олеговеса. Член исполнительного комитета ФИСУ Kairis Ulp, Executive Committee Member FISU, Kairis Ulp. Талисманы вручают. Заместитель председателя правительства Российской Федерации Ольга Голодец. The mascots will be presented by Deputy Prime Minister of the Russian Federation, Ольга Голодец. Министр спорта Российской Федерации Павел Колобков. Minister of Sport of the Russian Federation Павел Колобков. Бронзовыми медалями за третье место по хоккею шайбой награждается команда.
So Japan being invited over to receive the bronze medals. They played an absolute thriller earlier today against the United States. It was 1-1 as we went to overtime, but they didn't need much of that overtime. Yoshihiro Enomoto settled the issue. Some real star players today. Chika Otaki, and shirt number 11, has been a crowd favourite right through the tournament. Seven goals. Miyazaki picking up one today. And it worked out a fairly efficient way to get through this big presentation. A few players confused. There's 10 Aota. And Shiori Kosuga, a tall defender. 169 centimeters, tall at least for this team. Like the mascot being handed out about two at a time. They've got a bit of a system here, so that's the way it should be done. And Yujiro Kasahara, head coach for Japan, assisted by Joe Araya. Well done, Japan. Lost their semi-final to Canada, but came out and won the bronze medal game, so lifted their position at the Universiade Winter Games by two spots, from fifth to third.
Kanade! The second place and the silver medalists.
Japan moved past the Canadian team. Disappointment still on the faces of these players. A smile or two here and there from the likes of Stanwood there, 16. They're trying to bear up. They had their sights set on the big prize, but it goes to the Russian Federation today. Puts me in the mind of the way gymnastics medal presentations happen. The gymnasts always congratulate each other on the podium, which is a nice touch.
Дамы и господа, еще раз приветствуем серебряными медалями за второе место. Награждается команда Канады. The second place and the silver medalist, Team Canada.
And Canada not quite sure of process now. Looks like they're going to move along and shake the hands of the Russian Federation first, then come up and get their medals and mascots. Quite a few of the Canadian families have come across. I've talked to a couple of them. They've had a lovely time in Krasnoyarsk. Can't speak highly enough the hospitality here in this lovely city, and the Canadians come over. Canada beat China 10-0, Japan 4-0, the USA 1-0, Switzerland 8-2, lost to the Russian Federation 4-2, and then of course today's gold medal match. Two-nil, final score. Manish Fofar, 27-3 there is Leah Balkan. Melody Bouchard, great player for Canada right through the tournament. Annie Berg had a big game today. Cassidy Milboris is number 7. And 11 is Cassandra Labrie. Like the system was broken down slightly on the presentation of the mascots and medals, but we're almost through. Down to the support team now for Canada. I think some heartfelt congratulations being offered there to this courageous Canadian team to get as close as they did for as long as they did. I do hope that when the sun comes up tomorrow, they'll realise they've done something pretty special collecting second place at the 29th Winter Universiade. And the moment many of the fans here have been waiting for, the introduction of the Russian team. Canadians skate back to position. First of all, warm applause from a very fair-minded crowd at Arena Sever. I don't think any Canadian fan here is disappointed in the effort offered today by their team.
They've been wonderful. Золотых медалей становится команда Российской Федерации.
And the Russian team comes forward, led by Anna Shabanova. First through. Katerina Kologova, 13. Another great match from her. Elena Staravojtova, Kilishova. Finally get to see what they look like with their helmets off. Well, Pavlova, one of the crowd favourites here, Valeria Pavlova. 10 goals in the tournament she had. Rogachova today was solid. Dupina took a couple of big hits towards the end. Shokina. There, Oksana Batisheva. Those medals are pretty substantial, aren't they? And they feel pretty good in the hand, I think, for the victors. Ashtareva, who scored the empty net goal, that really put the issue beyond any doubt. Like the Russian team are comparing medals and mascots. I think they're all the same. Russian sports minister handing out medals. Batalova. And to produce a lot of you like us. They're still very popular around the souvenir shops as a memento to take away from these games. Nadezhda Morozova, what a game she had as goalkeeper for the Russian Federation. Alexei Shistyakov pressures off, finally, and Alexander Vedinikov. They were feeling it today. There was one tough win to secure. Now they can smile. It's seen enough of hockey to know that it doesn't always come just because you expect it. Shout of congratulations goes up once more from the fans, not many of whom have left. They wanted to soak in every moment.
Дамы и господа, в честь команды победительницы звучит гимн FISU. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the FISU anthem.
Oh,
Yama's lyrics celebrates being young, being a university student. And they will celebrate, I'm sure, long into the evening, the Russian Federation team. And I hope the Canadians, as disappointed as they look, will quickly turn that around and realise they've had a great experience and done themselves proud here in Krasnoyarsk. Likewise, the Japanese team, who were thrilled to get their bronze medal victory over the United States today. And that confirms the placings for you. Gold to the Russian Federation in the women's hockey, silver to Canada, bronze to Japan. It's been a pleasure to bring you the action for the last couple of days. It's all for the women's ice hockey, of course, and just one day of competition left in Krasnoyarsk, and the closing ceremony to come too. So the defence of the title from 2 years ago, successful. I don't think the players want to leave the rink. They'll happily stay and listen to this, of course, for as long as the crowd wants to give it. But we're just about done here at Arena Seva for the Universiade of 2019. Photos, of course, to be taken. Here's a few moments from the day's action. We do hope you've enjoyed it. This squad will enjoy it for a little bit longer, that's for sure. And the women's ice hockey program draws to a close. Good to have your company again in the next day or so while we wrap up this Universiade from Krasnoyarsk. That's about all we have for you now from Arena 7.